I think like that is such a perfect example of how not only is it like important for us to like connect these issues to larger struggles, but it's imperative, right, that our state violence isn't dissimilar from state violence coming from the Israeli government, right? That because these things are interconnected, because they are based in the same systems of power and dominance and hegemony, like we owe it to our folks outside of the U.S. to be constantly struggling against these forces and to constantly be naming what those forces are and what they look like in different places, right? That in order to build like a really strong movement that connects us across borders and across different like issue specificities, we have to constantly be challenging each other of where to think about where our issues keep threading on in different areas, right? That it's important for us as organizers and activists and people who believe in values of liberation and values of resisting state violence, that we can't have tunnel vision when discussing these issues, right? And even if, you know, like Palestinian suffering doesn't immediately touch us every day in our own lives, that doesn't mean that our threads aren't connected and therefore need to be always emphasized, always theorized, and always discussed with other people.
Anyone else?
I was kind of trying to move around this definition of solidarity. I feel like we use it a lot in organizing, and there's a lot of things that we use and don't have definitions to, so I'm trying to like plug away at it. So one of the things that I thought of as like a working definition is solidarity is showing up and working to create a space that not only centers what your ideal liberation could look like, but to merge that with the liberation visions of those who may or may not navigate life similar to you do. And so what that means and why it matters is like you here in Durham at Duke, it's a very specific bubble that you're living in right now and navigating. And I've been there and I know that. And I know that in the past in organizing, I have received a lot of pushback from many different people, from the administrators here to random people who don't know what's going on. And they've questioned, well, like, why do you need to put business, like, you know, why do you need to be in other people's business? Why do you need to, like, question things? Like, this has nothing to do with you. Like, when we were organizing for workers, they were like, well, what does this have to do with you? You're not a Duke worker. But actually, first of all, I was, which was a whole thing. But it's like the ways in which we border ourselves. So we divide what, you know, a Duke worker looks like. And so I found myself really trying to break that border and really trying to push back people from that. So there was